that actually cache was NIP's pick.
I find that very hard to believe. Like I said before, I've casted them one other time on cache, and it was the exact same result. It was almost a mirror of what I just saw. So like they seem to don't be that strong on the map. It looks like they haven't got much to go on. I'm not sure why they would pick it, and it surprises me a lot. But I'm hoping they can pull out a bigger performance. If this is Dignitas's map, who knows what's going to happen, judging by NIP's performance on their chosen map. But as we say that, it looks like we'll be going into the pistol round right now, and we will have NIP starting on the CT side.
All right, so NIP had a disappointing Saturday, and we woke up thinking, well, they can turn it around at any given Sunday. Has it been that way thus far?
Well, this is it. All in now. Go big or go home.
It'll be Getright, who, you know, it's... we pick on Getright and say he's had a bad day because Getright sets standards that are just ridiculous.
Absolutely.
But ultimately, he has had a bad tournament by his standards that are so, so high. And we'll see whether he can... Well, nope. Simpix will get the first frag and the headshot bomb planted. And NIP had two players over on B, and so having anyone in there, particularly when they found Getright so quickly, was never going to be easy. They're now going to have to go for the retake, but it was, again, it's this one-by-one stuff from NIP that they lose another man, they go into all of these engages just one-on-one, and there's always two or three Dignitas players just shooting at the one guy poking their head out.
Yeah.
It's easy for Dignitas at the moment.
Well, I think, especially on Inferno, the T-side pistol seems to be one, in my opinion, almost like 80% of the time. If you can kind of coordinate a nice push, blocking armor up and just taking the bomb site, that normally is the outcome, to be honest. So NIP can't be too disheartened by that. I think it's they'll be able to do exactly the same here. But we can see an interesting buy coming in now from the CT side.
Yeah, Getright. Well, we called the AWP a plan B. What would you call this?
Plan X. when all else fails, pull this out.
It'll be Device to be the first man coming at him with his P90. So those shots rattle away, and NIP thus far have not faced off against any of these Dig players, but they will do shortly. And this is an all-in move.
Yeah, absolutely.
To turn the tide of the game.
Perfect situation right now for them.
And there's the first frag, it comes from Freiburg, and here he goes! The shotgun power delivers nothing as Exist gets one, Forrest follows up with another, and now Forrest, oh, you were ready to scream, ready to be excited for Forrest, but it didn't happen, and here now Fiflaren is one on two, Dupree and Fetish, as the bomb has been planted, and NIP are resting their hopes on Fifi once more, as he will walk in and...
It's quite interesting on cache, the exact same thing happened. Like Dignitas, kind of, when they choose a bomb site, they kind of commit to it, even though they ran into another stack of NIPs there on the bomb site. Once they find out, they still just commit to the bomb site. Most teams would kind of run off and say, oh, it's a stack, get out of there. Dignitas kind of commit, and they always seem to come out on top of this situation. Even when Getright had that fantastic position with the Nova there, you would have expected him to get at least one or two frags, but nothing came to fruition for him. But yeah, great work from Dignitas, and they managed to not lose too many guns there, actually. So that's going to force NIP onto a complete full eco. I think we can see a few CZs, actually, but no armor this time.
Be Fetish to get frag number one onto Exist. And for your money at this point in time, what do you change? I mean, we've all been in a situation where we're expected to do something and we're just floundering.
Yeah.
How do you galvanize this this NIP side?
I think they need to be in the driving seat here. Although they're the defensive side in CT, I think they need to be ones initiating the round itself. I think I want to see them kind of doing their more aggressive play style here. That's when you're sending CT's down the banana with the smokes, kind of taking that dominancy and kind of showing that you're controlling the maps. You're not going to just sit back and let them control it. I think that's how you kind of guarantee yourself rounds with a no-fear play style and kind of showing that you're the dominant side and the better players, as it were. I think it'd be great to see them kind of utilize an AWP effectively as well. But depending on how the first buy round goes, I think we'll see whether what kind of strategies they'll be employing to be fair.
And how do you analyze Dignitas? Because, I mean, the best words I can come up with to describe their performance is they've made no mistakes.
That's it. They don't do anything too exciting or crazy. It's all just quite traditional kind of smoke off choke points, work together, go pick for pick. The best thing about what Dignitas does, whenever they lose a frag, there's always a man to back them up straight away to get that frag back. And that's the most important thing is, yes, as soon as a comrade goes down, you're there to kind of back him up. And even if he dies, you get the kill straight back. A lot of teams will kind of be spaced out to kind of make that happen. They can see like one or two of frags being taken down, but Dignitas seems to be so good at those return frags.
But if it's that simple, why can't anyone do it?
Well, it's not that simple. It takes a lot of chemistry and teamwork and good communication and a good in-team leader to kind of read the game and get you into those situations where you can be taking those frags as easy as they have been. Oh my goodness.
It comes in from Device, and NIP just can't get a break as their Talisman Forest Head is left rolling around on the floor like that of Ned Stark's. NIP are just reeling here. And if we're going to go for one more reference, it's been a bit of a red wedding.
That one's lost on me.
No spoilers. And this is just Dignitas at their very best. The game they played against VODS Pro yesterday was very similar.
Yeah.
It was dominance from start to finish.
Yeah, absolutely. Once they get into the flow of things, there's no stopping them.
And then you factor in this going into Cologne. As it'll be Fifth Laren to see action as Dignitas have this time pulled back, and Fifth Laren will be unable to get involved courtesy of that smoke, but existing Get Right help him out. Zipnix dispatches of Get Right as he goes in, and now it will be Fifth Laren who's chased around, stop the plant, almost follows up onto AZ, whose headshot ends Fifth Laren's life, but it is a whopping 24 points of health between the two of them. You could tickle Zipnix and he'd die, and he will wait for Freiburg and Exist to make their move, and he has got one shot and one shot only. And he didn't take it. So he will eventually go down, and NIP get on the board. And for NIP fans, this is your moment.
Absolutely. I think that plan there from Dignitas was quite sloppy. They didn't seem to have anyone covering the quad there. And Fifth Laren managed to stop the planter. Now I think that was the moment the round was won. Dignitas looked like they kind of almost had that round in the bag. They kind of took middle very nicely, got that first kill on apps. The bomb was going down, but I think it was just a lack of concentration there, and the Fifth Laren did great work to get the bomb down. And here we go. Nip in the driving seat for the first time of this campaign, I think. So we can still see a full buy from Dignitas. The money is not going to be too affected by that first round loss.
Yeah, when we say driving seat, we're talking about driving a Mini, not a Ferrari. They won one round.
Yeah.
And we're searching for optimism because that's how dominant Dignitas have been. It'll be Device firing in towards the smoke. Thus far, no one's connected onto either side, despite much munition being dispatched. And there will be the first tickle of a shot. It'll be Forest down to 48. Yes. Dignitas again. Nothing sloppy. There is, we talk about we'll come back to this point in a second, as Freiburg will see action here as AZ comes walking on to the end of his AK. Oh, Freiburg got to be careful here because he's almost taken down his teammate. It was Freiburg got the second under Dupree, but Fetish and Zipnix ended that of Freiburg and Forest, and the bomb goes down. Exist has Zipnix coming at him, and will fly a second. Exactly what you talked about, a second man there to help him. Exist will think he's safe and won't
there
be aware of that second man that is Zipnix. As Henry G, the prophet, proven right. As Fifth Laren goes up against Zipnix, who has been just special this tournament. He's just delivered again and again for them. Now Device, one on two, they're lined up right in front of him, and Fifth Laren this time does get the kill. The bomb is going to be defused. And NIP get their second round in a row with just one man left to spare. The crowd find their voice. An NIP favored crowd.
Yeah. Well, I think that was The tactic executed by Dignitas there, it was almost perfect. The way they got into the bomb site was really, really nice. Didn't really see, they flushed the CTs out on the bomb site, kind of made them face with the Molotovs and the smoking of the choke points. But can't take anything away from Nip there. The retake was fantastic. That work on Ruins kind of getting the opening frags. So great work from them, and that's going to be a huge round for them. That's actually going to knock Dignitas onto their first eco of the game. And this is where Nip really need to start stringing rounds together if they want to have a successful CT campaign. The next gun rounds in particular is going to be huge for them.
There it is. Freiburg and Forest helping themselves, adding up on the scoreboard for them. There'll be more than welcome of that. You know, we talked yesterday a lot about having flair players like Shox and Kenny S, for example. Dignitas don't have one of those.
I don't think so, but I think they've got like AZ, they've got Device, they've got people that can have those huge moments. But I think, like, you're right, I think they've got also got players that kind of just do their job. They don't have to go do anything too crazy. They're not running around like doing 360 no-scopes or going for big wall bangs and stuff. They do consistently play well. They don't have to be
They don't allow
erratic.
A roamer.
Exactly. I think that's why they play the style they do. They kind of everything's quite set out. Everything's quite methodical. And that's why they do so well. I think that's they play to their strengths. And I think we'll see another kind of execution here in a similar position. We see the bomb kind of edging towards that B-site area now.
It's Device who is the furthest forward for Team Dignitas as shots traded between the smoke.
Yeah, I think the idea of this is you want to bait out all the grenades the CTs have available, so you can see them using those smoke grenades to kind of lock the Ts out. If they can bait those out early on in the round, it means that when they go to execute on this bomb site, perhaps they won't have to run through the smoke grenades or anything like that. So this is what they're trying to do. They're trying to bait out anything available the CTs have in their arsenal right now.
Meanwhile, on the other side of the map, it's McLaren starting to see action. As the Dignitas push will now come in towards that A site. Exist is going to see a lot of action.
Oh, wow.
Zipnix gets himself the first on to get right, but Exist firing blind does get a kill. AZ goes down. Device and Dupree, though, get two of their own. Fetish follows up with frag number four for Team Dignitas, and it is Forrest now alone up against four. Some of them very low health, but Forrest not interested.
It looks like if you see how much damage existed there. He had them all lined up almost perfectly for him there. And I think if he had an opportunity to fire five more bullets, he could have actually got a four man. He only managed to take one down with him. And yeah, great work from Dignitas there. Kind of like that play, that team play style we see from them, kind of just smoking off one area, making sure they go. And it's kind of simple play. That's what wins lands. Like, especially when you're not an environment you're particularly comfortable with and you're not relying on people to go absolutely sick. You kind of just stay together, frag for frag, and make sure you stay as a unit. And that's exactly what they did, and that's kind of it's working really well for them. That's a huge round that's going to take them into the lead now.
And Fiflaren looks like he's got the weight of the world on his shoulders there. That's not a happy NIP. Getright, who has been subdued this weekend, but is capable of anything and everything.
Oh yes, definitely. Never write him off.
Has just one frag in these seven rounds, though. And let's see what Dignitas can do. 4-3 in favor of the Danes. With a... Laren is firing down middle with the smoke. We'll pull back. It's Freiburg in a cracking position here if Dignitas do decide to test him. He and Forrest are definitely capable of mixing everything up. It's interesting when you think about Banana and B and Freiburg. It's his home from home. Despite that, the NIP defense has been breached four times.
Yeah, we can see all those smoke grenades being used quite early on in the round and in the grand scheme of things. And we can see Dignitas has almost edging towards where their final destination now, time ticking away.
Now, what worked yesterday for NIP on this map was Getright being a free spirit.
That's what the best CT teams do. They kind of roam around and kind of do surprising things that don't allow teams like Dignitas, who have quite set strats, you just kind of knock them off and you need to get the first frag against teams like this. But I won't go into that now, as this execution is going on to the A-bomb side.
Fiflaren and Exist both get a kill. This has come at the cost of Getright, but frag number three and four will be delivered by Exist, and this time he does get the rub of the green. Dupree, one on four, gets himself Fiflaren for his troubles, and then says, you know what, maybe I'm not done just yet. Exist outed, and the CT side will just play to the clock, and it'll go to 4-4, but Dupree finishes off with a hat-trick. And for a team that lost the previous round, that does add expense.
Yeah, absolutely. You can see the money in the CT camp is not great right now. They're going to have to perhaps sacrifice some armor here. We can see an interesting buy there from Getright. like I was mentioning before, one of the best things you can do on this map is take the first T-pick, especially against a team like Dignitas. They rely so heavily on their set executions onto like things like the banana bombsite, and you can see them when they take A, it's quite methodical. So they want to take that first frag and kind of take out their key players and their strategies.
Look at that nade that there. They knew exactly where Freiburg might have been. Mm. And 43 points of health will go away. So Freiburg stands tall, stands strong. More smoke added to the flames. And they just instinctively are aware of, well, what is a common position, but is also one Freiburg has made of his own, and they forced him out. He retreats, and Getright has been anchored to that A site this time around.
Here it comes.
As it'll be Freiburg and Forrest to get onto Device, who is the furthest man forward and does in the end get the better of Forrest. Freiburg gets himself that famous frag. Fetish and Exist trade on the other side. Fifth Laren is going to come on to Fetish, but that is but only a diversion because Freiburg was the prize. And the B bomb site has been won as Fifth Laren comes around. Does have a very low health assistant to come with him, but they're 2-on-3 here, and Getright will be looking for something more effective than what he's got. Faces off against the Zipniks, both fully armed and in tip-top form. And there he is, Getright. Doesn't matter for him. That's a great hit as he pushes in towards this site now. Fifth Laren is ready to go for this. Can he connect on the first frag? Oh, had he done so, it would have opened everything up for Getright. But the bomb will blow and Getright will escape.
You know what was great about that round from Dignitas? They kind of almost, it was a double fake almost. So they kind of did the same smokes they did on the first gun round. They allowed them to get into that bomb site, send one person in, and it was kind of like, it looked like they were kind of selling a fake there, and they like, wanted to see where we could find that first frag. He found the frag there, and then it looked like they only called one person was in, and I think you saw no CTs really rotating. They were kind of anticipating it to be a fake, and then all of a sudden, an army of terrorists started swarming the bomb site, and it kind of really tore the CTs apart, and I think we can see them on a really disjointed buy here. It looks like it's kind of quite a desperate buy almost to kind of get himself back in this game.
Sure. Freiburg went looking, and he and Forrest have both been picked apart. Exist is in a tricky position here. Not going to get past AZ, and Dignitas will jump up into what should be a 6-4 lead unless someone like Fifth Laren can get himself some kills, but I think he's going to be more happy to get a gun out of this round.
Silly buy, in my opinion, there. I think they should have probably waited till they could get the economy back on track and kind of gone for another full buy and maybe had a change of approach to the rounds. I think they definitely need to start being more offensive and kind of getting in the faces of Dignitas instead of them allowing to have so much freedom on the map now. They just seem to be getting up to the top of Banana and kind of just executing their tactics and kind of having that free roam to have someone walking through apps and stuff like that. It just seems like there's way too much freedom for Dignitas right now. If Nip want to get back into this, they need to kind of show their dominance on the map in other areas, at least take control of one part of the map just to kind of get some information at least.
So they've sat back on Banana. Freiburg is not keen to push down Banana this time, like we saw Fnatic do yesterday, for example.
Sure.
So if they're not going to have that, is the option to put in an AWP, the Henry G plan B?
Well, it depends. With the money like it is, definitely not. But they're going to have to do something. They'd like I said, pushing down Banana is the first thing to try out. If you can lock that off, and Dignitas seems to be favoring the Banana bombsite so far. We've only seen them execute away properly once. Now that's going around hard, and that wasn't really a strategy as such. It was just them seeing an opportunity and taking it as a team. I think that they just need to show some dominance on any parts of the map. They need to lock down something instead of being weak across the board right now.
And how much is that easier said than done, given the predicament that they're in?
Well, right now it's going to be almost impossible. They keep getting... by having these like, almost silly buys, like kind of a couple of pistols, some famuses, no head armor and stuff like that. And they need to stop doing that. I think they need to sacrifice a couple of rounds here at the, like they might be doing now, and kind of getting the economy back on track. And maybe perhaps trying out the AWP, getting Fifth Laren the AWP on Arch perhaps, and giving him an opportunity to have a face down middle. Because the Dignitas haven't got AWPs right now. They could just pick up, the CTs could pick up an AWP and start working the picks. I think Dignitas have got themselves into a position where they feel quite comfortable. They know they can face areas and not have the one-shot kill gun looking down at them. So I think they're definitely a change of tactics and they're back to the drawing board perhaps. This is although Dignitas really are taking the lead right now, it's definitely not over. CT can still win the half at this point. So let's see what they've got up their sleeves and whether they can have a change of play style here.
Dignitas, three rounds up, 7-4. Remember, this is knockout.
Yeah, absolutely. This loser goes home, unfortunately. And if you just joined us, Dignitas took the first map, which is D-Cash. It's all to play for now.
Which was NIP's pick, we later found out, yeah. And it was a stomp.
Lambs to the slaughter.
It'll be Get Right to see action first as here come the Danes once more. Get Right can't connect with the first frag, is going to get picked off, but Fiplarin then sees two, gets two, and we trade two players on either side. But it's Dupree who just has been beautiful today, who will finish off the job, and Fetish versus Freiburg, who will spot the other first? It should be Fetish, but it isn't. Freiburg gets himself the kill, and this opens up for NIP. They're two on two, but Sipnix doesn't have much left in the tank for this one. That Molotov will force them around. Freiburg with the rotating frag on towards Sipnix is going to go up against Dupree now, and Dupree gets the first frag, and then will be allowed to come in for the second, but Forrest in the end gets it. And there was the frustration because they know that could have been theirs. And
It's going to be close.
Oh, he's not going to get it.
Oh, no. Devastating for Nip. That was a round they needed. You can see the economy is so weak there. Just with no kit on Forrest there, you can see how weak it was. And that's going to force him onto yet another eco, unfortunately for them. Dignitas running away with this one again, it seems like. Arguably the more difficult side on terrorists, but they've got a very, very good half indeed so far. Eight rounds to the good, and with only a couple more rounds to play, you've got to ask yourself, can Nip get back into this? Is it too far gone already?
And this crowd, you can tell they're all Nip fans, because they clapped when they saw the Nip
one. A quiet golf clap every time a round is one for Nip.
And then when Dignitas actually won that round, not one person clapped.
Sure. I think people want to see good
characters. And look, they've even isolated the Dignitas manager. He's sat in his own with Thorin, just like, no one likes us. I've only been supporting UK esports for 10 years. 8-12, Dignitas. 8-12, 8-4, I'll learn to read. And this is a real statement of intent from the Danes. Who would want to go up against this side right now?
Not Nip, apparently.
That exists is just in a really horrible place right now. Scott. Oh, gets himself a kill as Dupree is downed, and it'll be exist outed by Sipnix this time, and the remaining players will come at him. But that will be round 13, Dignitas. They've got two more. The best they can hope for is 9-6. Yeah, if we're really looking for positives, they'll want a full pistol conversion on their T side, which is doable.
Yeah.
And that would level the scoreboard up. But Dignitas, as a CT side, a side who just loved to defend.
Yeah, I think they've got such a massive mountain to climb here. That's what we mentioned. This is Dignitas' map. This is their home map. They chose this one, which is, oh God, could have been huge. But yeah, this Dignitas, when they go on that CT side, they really are the sort of team that kind of surprises you. They'll be pushing down Banana. They'll be setting up Orcs in middle. They'll be the ones calling the way the round will be going. They'll be the ones taking the momentum and kind of using it in their advantage. So I think it's going to be very difficult for Nip to get him back into this. But as we can see a change of approach here for Nip, a chance to get these last two rounds and kind of potentially turn this round and hopefully get enough rounds to take this map in their favor.
And it's all in from that guy, as Exist has left nothing left, as he is going to get picked off by Fetish. And no sooner did they listen to your advice, did Dignitas answer back up with a great kill. McLaren. I wonder whether he'd be tempted to go and pick up that weapon, but hasn't been. Finds himself Flash Fetish. Only lost 66 points of health in that engagement as well. you see Dignitas just patiently waiting. They've got the first pick. They're wondering, is there a second? As they will push up, it's going to be Fifth Laren to get dropped by Device. And just man for man in this game, Dignitas have been that much better. Those exchanges have always gone in the favor of Dignitas. And get right as I say that. Gets himself that next kill, and it'll be four-man push in towards the B site where Forrest is waiting patiently to unleash as he goes for the first, looks for the second, but he's got two guns trained on him at all times. Getright coming in now with the assistance of Freiburg as they will know that with only two rounds left in this half, they kind of have to go for it as they will make entry. And there's low health on all of those players. This isn't an impossible 2-on-3 by any means. Getright gets himself the first. What's interesting is at all times you can't see that last man. Getright gets himself three. That's there wasn't 100 health between them, though.
Huge stuff, but yeah, they needed that round desperately. If they've got any chance of winning this map, it's going to be plays like that that get them back into the game. And you see the crowd are loving it. Look at that. Great stuff. Yeah, it almost looked like Dignitas had that round completely wrapped up. They got into the B-bomb, so I had the man advantage, but perhaps a little bit too much of overfacing there when the bomb was down. But yeah, fantastic work from Getright there, and we can see yet another change of tactics here for NiP. I think this is what they needed to be doing earlier on in the game. It seems like they're adapting to what Dignitas are doing, but it might be too little too late in this situation.
Yeah. So Forrest, who will go in, and you can see AZ just really, whilst he's slowly coming up there, he's not that afraid of what might be lying up for him. Certain to that point that they've had no reason to be afraid that there might be an AWP waiting for them. Zipnix has dropped Getright, who picked up that great hat trick at the end of that last round. Fifth Laren will move in. That Molotov in towards the pit will just push any NIP players that might have been there out, but they're not. And Fifth Laren will be assisted by that AWP of Forrest, who gets frag number two for this round. And Forrest will hope to close this one out. They have a two-man advantage here. And Forrest just with a slither to hit out of Zipnix, didn't quite make it, but at the same time is relaying exactly where everybody is and is covering that balcony entrance, allowing Exist to get the frag onto Fetish and Zipnix to go down. And it's a great half from Team Dignitas. They are 9-6 up going onto their favored side.
Yep.
And Fifth Laren, you see there, has some rallying of the troops to do.
Absolutely. Well, They should take this pistol round. I think we see a lot of T rounds going in the favor of the T just because of how strong the Glock 5x armor situation is. You kind of just choose a place, kind of feel out the map, and then you just burst in together. There's not really much the CTs can do to stop that. So we hopefully should see this going to 9-9 if all things go to plan for NiP. And then we might have a game on our hands, depending on how the first gun round goes and whether NiP can build up that momentum. I'd like to see it happen. I'd love to see this be a close game and then to get back into this one.
Well, we aren't live in the pistol round, so we will spy. AZ and Dupree momentarily seeing action, but it's Freiburg who's next up. What a almost perfect nade. Dupree's down to 69 points of health as he's seen some action, but Freiburg likewise getting shot at over on the B side as he advances further and further, and he entertains Fetish and Dupree more and more. Device down to 3 points of health, and without a frag, they've done over 100 damage here, the NIP side. Fetish will say, there's a very angry Freiburg at the door. Dupree, though, does get the first frag, and it's Forrest that's going down on the other side of the map, and NIP now are going to be forced into that push as we switch over. It's probably B where we should be, though, as Freiburg will now go in. Freiburg gets himself the frag onto Zipnix. Fetish still alive. Fetish still fragging. Exist gets one onto Fetish, and Getright follows up onto Dupree. Device out as well, and all those low-health players suddenly with no health. AZ is the last man, and he's all in, and, well, they're going to go and play right into his hands here as he moves across, and he
bomb has been planted.
This will be one hell of a take back from AZ as he makes his way forward. Getright will be the man sat deep as he rattles off a few shots between him. AZ's job is to find the man behind him, though, and Exist does a great job of just forcing AZ into this split personality syndrome. Do I shoot forward? Do I shoot backwards? Where do I go?
Yep.
And NIP and the NSA go straight to hell. That's round NIP.
That's exactly what we want to see from NiP. really nice kind of teamwork there towards the end, kind of left AZ having to do kind of just 180 spins constantly, and then as soon as he turned around, the terrorists had disappeared. Good plan from them, good round, and let's see, hopefully they can transfer that into two more. Hopefully no silly mistakes here, but as usual, the CZ is coming out with full force, and Dignitas will have very different ideas as to how this round will be going.
What is your take before we get into the action of this round? What is your take on the CZ rounds? You don't seem to, as a purist, you don't seem to be a fan of it.
I think that they still, after they were nerfed slightly, I still think they're a little bit overpowered. Just on, especially on maps like these, I think it almost makes it a gun round, especially when the guys armor up. If you can hold angles, and it seems like 90% of the time they get the entry frag, but it adds a level of skill for the T's. Like, they can't just run around and do what they want on the eco rounds anymore and just look for frag hunt. They have to approach the round properly, like they're doing now. NIP are playing this like a gun round. It's not as easy. It's not easy frags on the board. They know their CTs can be holding all these different angles on the map. So I think it definitely adds an element of tactical gameplay to CSGO. And I don't necessarily think that's a bad thing that you've got something like the CZ available to you.
Great hit there from Forrest. AZ goes down and Device is next, and this is more like it. NIP checking every corner, except for that one.
Apart from the apps.
Bloody hell! Really, just sold me out there, NIP. And it's Device, the last man standing. And I'll toss up that Molotov, and that will really burn that body down. And NIP convert, and the crowd—they're desperate for NIP to do well. They're cheering, they're cheering the pistol round conversions.
Yeah, well. NIP need them, to be fair, so I think they need all the encouragement they can get. They really can't let anything slip here, and we're going to see a very similar round coming up here. Interestingly to note, like, Dignitas don't opt for the same sort of playstyle NIP do on these eco rounds. They don't seem to be stacking and hiding in bomb sites. They seem to spread themselves out a little bit more, but as we say that, it looks like something a little bit more aggressive will be coming towards them. It's going to be a big battle on the banana area. DC's running down, they're seeing what they can do, but NIP seems to be mowing them down with no real trouble whatsoever.
In a round like that, you've got very little to lose. You've analyzed in the last one that you've not got much. You know, Dignitas checked almost every angle.
Exactly.
Sorry, NIP did. So nothing to lose. And we didn't see anything like that from NIP. They didn't really go all in on any of their save rounds.
Yeah, so they kind of just opt to kind of hide and hope for the best. They don't seem to just go kind of... NIP don't seem to like want to surprise their enemies. They just kind of want to be the ones that are kind of hoping and waiting for the terrorists to come to them, almost. So, yeah, that was an all-in move from Dignitas. Didn't go that there in their favor that time, but here we go. The real game begins. We are 9-9. One map in favor of Team Dignitas. This is going to be a huge gun round, and NIP will be looking to take this one if they're going to get some sort of campaign started here on D-Inferno.
You can see Fetish's goal there, picking up the Famous. He's thinking long-term.
Oh, yeah. See, he wants to get that money built up nice and strong.
It will be a Device going in, gets himself the first. Dupree helps himself to the next. And NIP have started this round in the worst possible fashion. And with those two players moving out, Getright is just a little late to the party coming out and towards mid now. And Dupree will do some damage and trade with Getright about 40 points of health each. And flash after flash. Fetish now with his Famous. There, Getright has his job now is really to be loud and not die. If he can draw out some fire from someone like Device and not die, then it would have been perfect foil for what's about to come. That wasn't the case, and what's about to come is the end of NIP's fourth round as Zipnix gets it. And talk us through that.
I think, like, as you mentioned before, Getright really did have to make a kill there. I think there's one person dying on Arch. He's not going to sell a fake in any sort of capacity. Didn't even draw a CT away from the banana site, and they actually started shooting through the smoke before anything else, before the T's had a chance to execute. Took one down, and yeah, for me, that was just a little bit too obvious. Getright had to make a kill there for that to even have a chance of working. And that's going to not leave NIP in a terrible situation, but definitely not in a good one. They're going to have to definitely have to win this round and kind of answer back to that after that almost close round. More tentative play here for NIP.
It's almost a replica of their defensive side.
Yeah.
They don't really go looking for that much. They're rarely the ones to get the opening kill.
Yeah, I think they kind of wait for their opportunity. They wait for the time to kind of to kind of run down a little bit and see if there's any opportunity for them to kind of make their move. They don't want to make that decision for themselves, I don't think. I think they kind of see whether the CTs will make a mistake for them. And in this situation, it looks like Freiburg will actually be the first one to make the mistake. VODS in a great situation here. Oh, VODS almost been taken down.
Yeah, almost for Freiburg, but no cigar. Sorry, almost for the Dignitas guy, who is dead. Device, there we go. I'll catch up. Apologies. As Dupree now has one moving in on him, and it's going to be Forrest who collects the frag. But AZ's in there with heads ablaze and gets himself the first, and they will now move in NIP. They've got a great opportunity to...
Huge.
Oh, big kill there onto Fifth Flower, and right in the thick of that site. Bomb, though, is going to go down courtesy of Forrest and Get Right, but they're up against two here, and they're on a health disadvantage as... the Dignitas sandwich will begin to come in, and just when you would have thought Forrest would connect, he didn't. Get Right blinked at the wrong moment and looked to the right, right as it was in front of him. And Dignitas get the rub of the green on that one, and it will be 11-9 Dignitas.
Yep, managed to get a bomb down though, so it's not everything's lost, but yeah, you sort of see how well Dignitas has approached those retakes. It kind of just pins her so perfectly. It kind of left Get Right in a situation where he has to look at both men at the same time to have any sort of chance of getting the round there. But good work from Dignitas, getting themselves on the board and kind of starting to run away with this one a little bit. We're going to see another buy here from Nip, kind of hoping that's not a full buy. This is definitely an all-in round from them. Freiburg there kind of wielding the big silver gun to see what he can do with it.
Zipnik's though, going hunting. And gets himself rabbits as he gets himself those next two kills. It's Exist and Freiburg that both go down, and NIP's round is almost already in tatters. They must get this next frag. As back, Get Right is the next man up and does get the next frag. Dupree down in classic Get Right style. Give him a pixel, he'll happily hit it. And Dignitas, though, not going to be drawn into any aggression. You can't get a rise out of Dignitas with something like that. They don't get angry. They just get revenge. Now, interestingly, after that kill, they did begin the rotation over towards that A site, which is now coming back. Who is that player? It was Fetish. Fetish moved over towards A. He's now going to sit in a little of a halfway spawn position.
This is where Nip are waiting for the CTs to make that first mistake. They don't want to commit to anything just yet. They want to see if there's any opportunity or window for them to make a frag before they have to commit.
And that timing has sent Fendish back.
And here we go.
It'll be Device to go on in. Device is going to be the first man to see action. It's Get Right. They keep firing at Device as it goes through that box. Forrest will get the first. AZ down. Device follows. And Fetish now going to have to come in and save the day as he leads that charge. Actually comes in quite early, Fetish, before reinforcements have arrived. As bomb planted. He couldn't prevent that. Three men after one, but not much health between any of them. As Zipnix and Fetish will now make that pincer once more. But Get Right gets the better of Zipnix. And Fetish is alone as he will go looking for Get Right and will not get past him. And that was more like it, NIP.
Yeah, nice controlled play from them. They're waiting for their opportunity. They saw it, smoked off the key area there, which is the pit in that case. Managed to get the bomb down with just no time whatsoever to spare, but it was just enough. Bomb going down with 4 seconds left. And a great afterplant play from them. It kind of stifled their CTs and didn't even allow them an opportunity to get onto the bomb site. So yeah, good to see and positive play from Nip. I think that'll be a sign of things to come. If they can just build on that and get a few rounds together, I think they might have a chance. This is the perfect round for them to get back into this and start building momentum. We can just see the CT buy there on the right.
And crucially in that round, they won the 50-50s. Oh, Fetish with a headshot. Dispatches of Freiburg and Get Right miss nades.
Overzealous play with Freiburg, I feel that. I don't think he had to face that angle without a teammate to answer back. That's what I'm talking about, people facing without having anyone to kind of back them up straight away.
It's Forrest that'll lead the charge for NIP, who find themselves a round down and a map down here against Team Dignitas in the quarterfinals of the Gfinity Counter-Strike GO tournament. $45,000 will be won here today in Stratford. As Get Right goes up against AZ. Around the corner he goes, and he had just milliseconds to make it count, and boy did he. It's AZ downed. Get right. 17 points of health, though, as Dupree will be flashed out. And that allows Get Right to get in and out before he saw him. Unfortunately, that was just onto the end of Device's weapon. Dupree gets himself the frag onto Exist, and Dignitas are picking up the frags here. Forrest did get Fetish, but he's alone, and he's not alive anymore. And that will beat 12-10 Dignitas, and the weapon advantage for NIP nullified.
Yep, absolutely, and that's one thing to note there. Winning one round and losing the following one puts you in a very horrible situation money-wise, and you can see there, it's got a force nip onto this eco round right now. Dignitas obviously looking to take this round. It's going to be a full Glock buy. Oh, as I say that, no, they changed their mind kind of last minute. Looks like they might be going all in on this round. They might be looking to actually win this one. You can see the selection of grenades we've got in terms of for nip. Interesting to see how they approach this. It looks like we'll be seeing a nice B take, kind of a full tactic being run here. It'll be interesting to see how it pans out for them. They haven't really done a full B execution yet.
Here we go. Zipnix lays down the fire, does get himself the frag onto Freiburg, the leading light, and with the Molotov and that AK from Fetish, they have come out of the flash and into two frags. And there's Fifth Flower and still alive. Exist gets himself one as well. That's two up for NIP, but still three men standing for Team Dignitas, and Exist is the last man up. Dupree is going to get that one. And well, they did damage on an eco round, but
yeah, I think they need to be kind of like take a leaf out of Dignitas' book there. They've obviously got these kind of set tactics. It seems like NIP kind of they want to get themselves into a position, an advantageous position, like they get control of middle, and they just kind of wait around there. They don't really seem to have a set execution where they see what opportunities are available. I think they should try those B takes that they have obviously got. They've got the grenades available to them, and I think they should see how that works out for them. And if not, you can even just do it like a faker one of those, kind of something a bit more methodical, and kind of see how that pans out for them. I think we've just seen a lot of the same for them so far, and they're relying on Get Right to get that opening frag, which he has been, to be fair, so they've been able to get the bomb down. But I'd like to see more set pieces from them.
How do you analyze Dignitas? You know, normally you go up against and say, well, I don't want to play this team on this map.
Yeah.
How do you analyze Dignitas just being, I don't want to play Dignitas on CT?
Well, that's the thing. Like, you kind of want to make sure you get the CT side first, perhaps. But, like, you can't be afraid of them. I think you just need to do your homework on them and see how they play. A top team will always do their homework on these sort of teams. If you just need to know how they play, how they approach their angles and stuff like that. And that's all you need to do, and just work out what areas they push. And like, they're definitely not unstoppable. I just think a lot of teams haven't caught on to the way they approach most maps yet. Especially on these kind of cash and nuke and stuff, they seem to be so dominant.
Frag for Device there as Get Right returns the favor with AZ downed, and Dupree will see action now as the nades come around. Fifth Laren just walks aimlessly onto the end of Dupree as he was nading to the left and Dupree was to the right. And now Exist is going to come in some 10 seconds later. Get Right might be the distraction. No, Dupree is here, there, and everywhere getting that kill. Exist is out as well, and it's Freiburg alone to go up against four big players, and he won't get past the first, and this is a mauling.
Yep, it's getting pretty desperate times now. We're going to see Nip in a pretty precarious position economically, and we can see another. This will be match point if Dignitas take this round. So, Big plays needed. It looks like NIP might have to go for the draw here. Oh, as we say that, something's happened.
Very late decision.
Very late decision, and is it the right one? I'm not so sure. They are all in.
But even if they did play for the draw and then overtime, that would require them stringing five rounds in a row, which
yep.
They've not done in this game. Match.
Yes, so.
So. See what they've got. It's that same 3-2 split again.
Yeah. I just don't think they've got the money available to them to do really anything else right now. Like we were talking about set pieces before, but with no grenades available, it's very difficult to execute those.
Someone's going to have to go big for NIP. Will it? Which one of the...
Here it is.
Superstars can it be? Each one of them has been muted here in London. UK's never been a really great place for Swedes to go into in esports. Forrest, though, gets himself the first frag for Device, as it'll be Dupree pushing in, and he gets himself fragged by Exist. And we were talking about big individual plays. Well, so far, Forrest and Exist have been the ones who have done it, and Forrest gets himself the next. And NIP are three frags to the good here, and Dignitas saying, actually, we don't want this fight. And NIP are going to pick up a round here, surely. And, well, whatever that buy was, it just about worked.
Just about, yeah. For a huge individual play from Forrest there, showing why he is ranked as one of the world's best players. It's huge. Big picks from him, and yeah, that was obviously the right move to make. They needed to do something big to get themselves back into this, and this could be the start of something great for them. They can string a couple together now and get the money back on track. There may be a glimmer of hope now, so they just need to make sure Dignitas do not get one more round, just to kind of give them a chance. They don't want to see that match point. It's so disheartening to see that come up on the scoreboard.
You want to see the difference between today and yesterday? In the games we were casting at Dignitas of NIP yesterday, they were hounding down people who were running away with weapons
Absolutely.
From a site.
I think they're just so careful now, and they know how important those guns are the key. They need to build the economy up and keep themselves on a strong roll. We can see a change of style here for Dignitas. I think they might be, they know that the victory is looming for them, and they want to surprise NIP with something a little bit different. I think Device might have something up his sleeve now to kind of reinforce and get this match point in their favor.
Well, let's see. This will be one of the killer moments here of the game. Dignitas.
Here it is.
Are two away from victory. NIP with just one round one there may have given themselves a slither of hope. The home team favorites, Ninjas in Pajamas, who clearly have a big following here in Stratford. Didn't know there was such a big Swedish community here. And they'll be cheering on NIP for a third map. But Device hasn't been able to execute yet. And just so you know why we've not said too much, they may be able to hear us, so we're reserved in what we can tell you. So far, only Fetish taking a slither of damage, but with the slow movement, Fetish has moved across here and gets himself the first frag. Picked off by Fifth Laren, but Forrest down is almost one and a half frags, if you will. As Device having to trade weapons there as he'll move in. I'm not sure he even fired off a single shot with it. And it'll now be Freiburg to take on Zipnix. And there's Device coming from behind with the AK, just as lethal. Gets himself that kill onto Freiburg. Exist now trying to take on Zipnix, and they're going to go right and left of the pond to get Zipnix, but it does cost them a lot of frags. It's get right 1-on-3 to save NIP. He's not going to be able to do it, and we'll go to 4. Match points.
Yeah, I think NIP kind of stifled themselves a little bit too much. They kind of opted for the kind of holding and waiting for the opportunity to find a frag. After losing the big scalp of Forrest there, I think they kind of ran the time down a little bit too much and kind of forced themselves to choose a bombsite pretty quickly. Worked their way into Banana and just weren't able to find the frag. I think Exist got a headshot almost straight away and kind of set the tone for the rest of the round. And it's going to leave them in a very precarious position right now. 4 rounds to get in a row to kind of keep themselves in this tournament. We've seen them do it before and come back from this kind of horrible situation. So can they do it again? Is there enough left in the NIP tank to bring them back into this Gfinity G3 tournament?
AZ is going to be the first one to see action as he saw a shoe, a Swedish shoe, escaping in towards the house. Device will pop around the corner and dispatch of the head of Fifth Lair, and then Dignitas are now just 4 frags away. And it has been like a good bottle of shampoo. Rinse, lather, and repeat for Dignitas. Each time they've come up against NIP, just showing one person, they've just picked it off, and then another person, and they've just helped themselves.
Fragments, I think. You're going to have to find something big. Time dwindling away.
Fetish knows. As Forrest goes down to Device, and we've seen this play before. We've seen it was Get Right on the other side that had to deliver frags, and he didn't. And now it's all on Exist. Rushing in towards that site. He's got to be caught in two minds. That smoke is helping him. But as the bomb goes down. He's 1-on-3 to save NIP. What does the old Warhorse have left in him? Device first, not going to get there. Can't get past the first hurdle.
There we go.
And Dignitas have demolished the ninjas in pajamas. High fives all round for the Danes as they demolish the Swedes.
Yep, absolutely. Fantastic work for Dignitas there. I think they kind of set the tone for the game. Big casting, mixed map, apparently. I'm not sure if that's been confirmed yet, but absolutely.